Shalom, Akiam. Your brother Kamal Mahar here, back at it again. First thing first, we give all praise to Yahweh, Bashem, Yabashah, Bashem, Rakakudash. Double honor to the apostles and elders and learners, true from GMS. Blessing to the Akiam, my dear, preaching his word, with our true sincerity. And blessing to the 1/3, 144,000 of the 1/3 of the house of David, the king, the house of David, the Biaf Davida. And Shalom to you, brothers out there speaking in different tongues and looking in different nations. Shalom. So today, brothers, I wanted to get into this video right here. I just came across, it was saying something like, alien and civilization report suggests there may be 36 intelligent aliens in the universe. Okay. Now, granted, Esau don't never know what they're talking about. You know what I'm saying? And then they're going to get into the galaxies and different things, that, you know, galaxies and the stars and other civilizations and other, you know, oceans and water and different habitable things on different planets, which I will probably have to agree that most likely it is. But then in the day though, Esau really don't know, and they don't understand what they're actually talking about when it comes to those galaxies and those stars and whatever it is they got going on, because that is of the Lord's house, you know what I'm saying? And so they don't understand that, you know, they're looking at it from like light years away and things of that nature, which, you know, in the terms of light year, could be, you know, I don't really know that knowledge. So I'm going to stay in my lane. But then in the day, though, what they're talking about and what they're getting themselves into is the house of Yahweh Bashem Yahushah. And, you know, that upper realm, what I guess we would call third realm, or the upper realm, I'm going to say, so I can keep myself and, you know, let my yeas be yeas and my nays be nays according to my knowledge of limitations. But I do know, you know, at the level that they're speaking of is the house of the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Yahushah. And that is where, that's also the dwelling place of where, you know, the Israelites will actually be able to have and actually get to way before Esau said he could. Because they're going to go into how they're going to go on the moon in 2024, and they're going to try to go to Mars right after that. See, they're going to try to do that, but they're not going to get that far. But the Israelites, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Indians of the elect, that's Lord willing, I'm one of those men that's, you know, through mercy and salvation, I get beamed up from the saving of Yahweh Shah, from Yahweh. You know, those are the ones that get those new bodies and get rescued through the so-called rapture, which the rapture is bullshit, but I'm going to say so-called, of that time frame of getting delivered through the second death. Those women and children and men, and also 144,000, those are going to be the men that's going to get the bodies like Yahweh Shah has, which I can get into that as well, which will have the opportunity and the abilities to be able to go into these galaxies and the stars that Esau so-called is saying they're going to pretty much try to get to, but they're going to try, but they're not going to make it. That's our dwelling place and our inheritance, which is the dominion of the universe, heirs with Yahweh Shah. That's just what that is. So I'm going to play some of this video. I didn't really want to ramble, had to say that, but I'm gonna go ahead and let it go for a second.
Humanity has faced two monumental questions since we first stood on 2 feet. Why are we here, and are we alone in the universe? Well, we may actually be closer to answering the latter. A study out of the UK is fueling theories that there are 36 intelligent alien races in just our galaxy alone. Joining me now to break it all down, theoretical physicist and author of The Future of Humanity, Michio Kaku. Thank you so much, first of all, for joining us. When I read about this late last week, you're the first person I thought of. So maybe we're getting closer to answering that question. Is there life outside of this, outside of Earth?
Well, that's the greatest existential question of all time. Are we alone in the universe? Let's do a science experiment. Go outside tonight, look up, see the Milky Way galaxy. You are now staring at 100 billion stars in our backyard, the Milky Way galaxy. And then make a ballpark estimate. How many of those stars have planets? How many of those planets have oceans? How many of those oceans have fish and aquatic life? How many of them have intelligent life? And so this is called Drake.
Now see, what this Edomite is getting into now, he's just basically coming from a Esau standpoint mindset that's very, very, very limited, and their wisdom is not as good as they think it is. So what he's going into oceans, he's going into, you see those beautiful figures, that's what the so-called Esau, so-called white man's technology can see from a telescope aspect. And they have really large telescopes all around the world where they can, you know, see really deep up into the heavens. And so, first things first, you know, what they're getting into in general. They're getting into, you know, just the Lord's house in general. What is that? The book of John. I think it's John. Right, it says, okay, I'm going to go start John 14 and 1. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in the Most High, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. Now, what is the Father's house? You know, the Father's house is actual, that whole heavens itself. That's where he dwell. But the earth is only but a footstool to him, which I'm going to get into that. So understanding that, which I'm going to get the scripture to prove that, it said, in my Father's house are many mansions. And if it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you. And speaking about the Israelites and the kingdom of heaven in general, which the Lord Yahweh Shah preparing for like about 2,000 years now. But in his Father's house are many mansions. What are those mansions? Or different galaxies, or different solar systems, different stars as habitable of other planets and things of that nature. Those are what you call the, in my Father's house, which is the that space aspect. And those different galaxies and stars and different things are mansions, or different mansions, the dwelling places of the heavens in general. So all those places where they so-called think that there's other life, or so-called other planets, or extraterrestrial, whatever bullshit he's talking about, which are the angels, is really, really, really in those dwelling places. Plus, he's gonna get into some chariots as well, and I'm gonna go ahead and elaborate on that too as well. But all those different things that they're saying, were oceans and different things of that nature, is all part of the Lord's, all part of the Lord's mansions in his house that Esau can't get to. You know, the moon and going to Mars and different things of that nature, what they're going to try to do, is all talking about the Father's house that they're trying to get to, but only the Israelites are going to be able to do so. And right here, here's a point. Matter of fact, let me go to straightly to the book of Psalms, actually. Psalms 104, maybe, let's see. I'm going to go start at 1. Bless Yahweh Bashem Yahushah, O my soul. Yahweh Bashem Yahushah, my power. Thou art very great, and thou art clothed with honor and majesty, who coverest thyself with light as with a garment, who stretch out the heavens like a curtain, who layeth the beams of his chambers in the waters, who maketh the clouds his chariot, who walketh upon the wings of the wind. Right. So all between the first verse up until the third verse, that's basically going into different. So like, okay, so to stretch out the heavens like a curtain, that's the vastness of so-called space right now. Different galaxies and different stars, all those different things that stretched out. It's all, because remember they so-called say that the universe is expanding. Well, the Lord stretched out the whole thing like a curtain, because that's his dwelling place in his house. And he's going into chariots on the third verse, which I'm going to get into as a video keep on going on. But at the end of the day, though, I did want to bring up Isaiah 2, 66. Isaiah 66 and 1. See, Esau think they know what they're talking about, but they really don't, though. It said, thus saith Yahweh Bashem Yahushah, the heaven is my throne. See, so all the galaxies and all the space aspect in general that we so-called say, well, not we, but Esau so-called say that they can get to, that's the Father's house, man. Not to mention the Lord separated a lot of stuff with the firmament, well, especially the waters from above. But in that dwelling place is the Father's throne, man. Well, all the vastness of space and what galaxies and planets that I keep saying, all that is the heavens, man. The heaven is my throne. That's his throne. That's where he dwell. We can't get there. And the earth is his footstool. The earth ain't nothing but a peon footstool to the Lord. That's why I said it's stretched out like a curtain. Because curtains stretch out. It's very vast. And what Esau say? They say, it takes such and such light years to get here and light years to get there. You know, like, come on, man. Like my brother Gabar would say, make this thing make sense. And it says, where is the house that is built unto me, and where is the place of my rest? Well, especially that's going into like when, was it Solomon? This is a good point. This is a good point. Let me go to the Second Chronicles. Because now we're going into the dwelling place of the throne of the Lord. It's vast in the spatial area they think they're talking about. They have no idea what they're really getting into. Calling by aliens and different things of that nature. Ain't no such thing as them green aliens and all that bullshit. Was it 2 Chronicles 6? That'd be like 6:17. It's a Solomon. So Let me get to the point. It says, because it's going into like, you know, I threw up a video going into how the Lord doesn't dwell in temples made with hands. And this was a good point when Solomon was saying. It was, he said, I'm gonna start at 18. It says, but you know what, 17. Now then, O Yahweh Bashem Yahushua, the power of Israel, let the word be verified which thou hast spoken unto thy servant David. But will the Most High very deed dwell with men on the earth? Behold, the heaven and the heaven of heavens. That's just making it, that's just not even exaggerating, it's giving you a realizations of how Esau is pretty close when it comes to verbal, like so many galaxies and different stars and, you know, 1900 light years away. Okay, you can use those words vainly speaking. Shout out to my brother Gabar. You can vainly speak and say that to give yourself a verbal standpoint of the vastness of what space is. I could say, as a man, you can probably use that terminology to describe the vastness of the heavens. So, but this is what the Lord was saying, because he was getting into, you know, basically like, also, it's not being built with hands. The Lord ain't dealing, but it's also a relation for what I'm trying to make in this video on how vast that the heavens are, which is the Father's house. It says, behold, 18 again. Behold, I was reading from the top. But will the Most High in very deed dwell with men on the earth? Behold, the heaven and the heaven of the heavens cannot contain thee. So that can't even contain the Lord Yahweh Bashem Yahushua at all. And then it says, how much less this house which I have built. Right, because you can't put the Lord in the box. The heaven and the heavens of the heavens can't contain Yahweh. So what more this little temple, little church building on 22nd and Woodstock gonna really do? Come on, man. You know what I mean? So Solomon was just making this thing clear, like, you know, like the Lord don't deal in his little ass box when he got the heavens and all the heavens. Come on, man. Like, how can you actually, you know, come forth with that? But that was my point to describe the vastness of what we're dealing with and what the Lord's house is consumed of. It's huge. So what this Edomites are talking about is hitting on the nose at a certain point. I'm gonna let this continue.
Breaks equation. Trying to get a ballpark estimate of how many civilizations there are in the galaxy. And that's where they came up with number 36. They took a bare bones, stripped down Drake's equation to get that number.
Now, what they're showing right now in the background is an actual chariot, which chariots actually dwell in those heavens, and they can, you know, so-called UFOs, they can go all through that. They go to the sun, the moon, all the different galaxies, all the different things, because the angels fly those things. You know what I'm saying? I could prove that as well. But at the end of the day, though, it's a lock here. Make sure we're still live. Okay, still live? Yeah. At the end of the day, though, you know, that's what Esau don't know. But we know. We know the so-called aliens, so-called, which are the angels flying the chariots, so-called UFOs. We know what they are and what they're in. And also how they're able to be in the heavens and the space and different realms and what Esau don't know, which I'm answering the question, is because they have that angelical body that Yahushua has, and also with the Israelites, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Indians of the elect will also inherit coming very soon. We look forward to that being perfect with the laws in our inward parts to be in a full righteous state. And then being in that righteous state gives us that angelical body, which that's the only body that can take that particular ability to have, being all those, being angelic like that, is the same bodies that's going to be able to have the ability to be in those galaxies and different places in space that Esau got to put a suit on, but the Israelites ain't going to have to. See, this is all in the scriptures, but the white-taking Christians ain't going to teach this thing. And so there's a bunch of question marks. There's a bunch of things Esau is trying to get into, but we can actually tell you how this thing worked. You know, I already threw a video up on chariots, but, you know, hey, that's not really what I'm getting into. But for the sake of what we're watching, you know, that's exactly what you're seeing, which is the chariots are the so-called UFOs. That's a chariot of the Lord right there. And that if you watch the actual real video with the Navy was getting into, they what they're actually recording is a chariot going at a speed that's unparalleled. See, right now it looked like something relaxed, but it's really not. It's really flying for real. But Esau has a technology to kind of so-called, you know, track them. Well, if the Lord wanted them to track them, but we see chariots on a high level now. But these chariots are the ones that can actually deal with those galaxies and different planets, which we will as well. It's a phenomenal thing to be an Israelite, man. It really is. So, like it, brothers, you know, I gotta, this thing is keep messing up on me. I'm gonna let this go
a
little more.
It's a fascinating number and it's encouraging. And I guess the question, though, is will they reveal themselves? Why haven't they revealed themselves? And what can we expect? Are they gonna be more intelligent than we are?
Well, that's called the Fermi paradox. Where are they? It turns out that if you have the Milky Way galaxy with 36 dots on it, each dot is separated by 17,000 light years. So in other words, even if we are populated with 36 extraterrestrial life forms, the distance is so great that we're not going to be able to communicate with them with radio or television. It would take 17,000 years for a TV signal to go from one planet to the next planet. It's not going to happen anytime soon. Sorry about that.
Okay, now through the spirit, he's right. Esau ain't gonna have no technology to be talking to no aliens. If they do, whatever, you know, I'm a speak to my limits of my knowledge. But Esau, what they're trying to do, they're not gonna do. Obviously, they say that they not gonna be able to. But this Edomite is about to say something through the spirit that's gonna be very, very monumental, and he's actually very right. Listen to this.
Okay, but there's no sense that they could have been so evolved and long before as they could be here. Maybe they think we're still, a few thousand years behind, and maybe we'll get a welcome to see, hey, you know, we've advanced somewhat as a civilization, but you don't want to dash our hopes that we might one day come in contact with E.T.
Well, I think that one day they may actually land on the White House lawn and announce their existence. However, as...
See, right there. I'm going to replay that one more time through the spirit.
Stephen Hawking...
...contact with E.T.
Well, I think that one day they may actually land on the White House lawn and announce their existence. However,
through the spirit, that Edomite is very correct. Yahweh's going to send Yahweh Shah and the angels to get busy down here. They're going to deliver the elect of the nation of Israel, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Indians, and they definitely going to make their presence known. Now, the chariots are already on the scene. We see, you know, the shout out to the NYC camp, main camp. They seen them. I seen the chariot before with my Akim online before. Another Akim and Esau and a heathen. So the chariots have been seen. But in the manner that he's talking about, he said that they're going to come one day and land on the White House lawn. Through the spirit, that's exactly what they're going to do. And they're definitely going to come in a very, very, very hostile manner. Very hostile manner. And so I just wanted to say that because my video was on the vastness of the Lord, man. It's all about, this video was based upon, you know, the universe and the stars and the galaxies or what they're trying to figure out what it is and where it is. It's the dwelling place of the Israelites, man. That's what that is. It's the dwelling place of the Israelites soon to come under Yahweh Shah, because it's Yahweh Shah's kingdom. You see what I'm saying? Then King David and 144,000 and on down. And things of that nature. But at the end of the day, though, he is very right, because like in other videos I have put up videos on, you know, Yahweh Shah coming back to deliver the elect and do destruction on Babylon and also the heathen and wherever place need to be, especially on Edomites, you know, and to bring down their rulership. That's what happened. See, it's symbolic. And he said that they're going to one day come down the White House lawn. Right. Well, let's look at the White House. Actually, it's the capital of Washington, which is the forefront of Babylon. So that's like, okay, so Washington is the forefront and the capital is the head honcho. That's basically representation of the whole entire Babylon. So yes, they are going to one day come on that damn lawn and destroy it all. I brought this out. This was edifying to you, brothers, man. You know, the Father's house has many mansions, man. It's going to be a beautiful thing, man. That's our dwelling place. What they're describing right now, stars, galaxy, and planets, is dwelling place and inheritance of the Israelites. I want to give all praise to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shah. Yahweh, He is the Being, exists by Hashem in the name and the only begotten Son, the Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shah, by Hashem in the name, and the Rekach Kodash, the Holy Spirit. The Rekach Kodash, the Holy Spirit. Double honors to the apostles and the elders, the learners, truth run from GMS. Blessings to the Aki, my dear, preaching His word, with whole our true sincerity. And blessings to the whole entire 1/3 and 144,000, Lord willing, one of those men. And Shalom to you brothers out there speaking in different tongues and looking in different nations. Shalom, brothers. We almost out here, man. That dwelling place that they're talking about, it's ours, man. We will soon be able to be in those different oceans and planets and stars and galaxies, man. It's a beautiful thing. Shalom, brothers.